Hi there. Today we are going to see the topic alcoholic beverages. Before coming to the alcoholic beverages, I would like to tell you some slogans that is from the book The Great Gatsby by Scott Fitzgerald. He says that first you take a drink, then the drink takes a drink, then the drink takes you. The second slogan, given by Charles Bukowski, she says that, that's the problem with drinking. I thought, as I poured myself a drink, if something bad happened, you drink in an attempt to forget. If something good happens, you drink in order to celebrate. And if nothing happens, you drink to make something happen. With these slogans, I would like to start the lecture. Let us start. What we are going to see in this lecture. So we have the meaning of alcohol. What are the meaning of alcoholic beverages? How is potable alcohol obtained? What do you mean by spirit? How do we classify alcoholic beverage? And what are the various types of alcoholic beverages available in the market? So, we come to meaning of alcohol. Or what is the meaning of alcohol? What is alcohol? When we say, it is a odorless, colorless and tasteless liquid. Again, I will repeat. It is an odorless, colorless, tasteless liquid which is obtained through fermentation. So this is done through fermentation. Fermentation means where the yeast and sugar reacts together to give alcohol and carbon dioxide. Again, I'll repeat. Fermentation is a process of reaction of yeast and sugar to give alcohol and carbon dioxide. Sometimes the carbon dioxide is left to escape, or sometimes it is trapped. So when we talk about this liquid, the juices should have sugar in it. That is where the fermentation takes place. Not only sugar, there might be natural yeast in the juices, or the yeast might be added to the juice. So now let us see the example. So juices of grapes. When we talk about the grapes has natural yeast which is present in the skin, as well as the sugar is also there in the pulp. So you don't want to add extra yeast. It depends upon the industrial policy, the company which is manufacturing or which is producing the wine. depends on them whether to add yeast or not. So juices of apple, it is called cider. Juices of pears, it is not known as perry. Barley, when you say, we use it in beer making. Potatoes, vodka, we use it in vodka. Rice, sake, grains, you can say grains for again for vodka can be used, they use it in vodka, they use it in gin, okay. Then cactus, and tequila making they use blue green agave, tequilana weber, etc. There are various types of alcohol. So here we are going to see only the ethyl alcohol, even though there is two types of alcohol we have. During the production process, we get two types of alcohol. One is methyl and another one is ethyl, or methanol or ethanol. But in the production process, ethyl alcohol is the principal alcohol. So only we are considering only ethyl alcohol. Again I repeat, there are two types of alcohol, one is methyl and ethyl. Methyl is poisonous and ethyl is a potable alcohol, which is drinkable alcohol. Meaning of alcoholic beverage. When we say alcoholic beverage, it means it is a potable or drinkable liquid. So I already said ethyl alcohol is a potable alcohol. So this consists of 1% to 75% of ethyl alcohol by volume. So ethyl alcohol is a potable alcohol which can be consumed to the limit. When we say alcohol by volume, ABV, that means the percentage of alcohol present in the liquid, in the bottle. In the bottle. You can see the ABV in all the spirit bottles, wine bottles, you can see how much percentage of alcohol is there in that bottle. The various countries has set the standards to sell alcoholic beverages. The government, particularly the government of various countries, they have their own standards of making alcohol. India also has the set standards for making of alcoholic beverage. Various states in India produces alcoholic beverages. Also certain states are where the alcoholic beverages are prohibited, like example Gujarat. Next we come to the bitters. Bitters are normally consumed for medicinal purposes. Traditionally it is an alcoholic beverage. Bitters are an alcoholic beverage made from the botanicals. Like example, cassicarilla, cassia bark, gentian, orange peel and cinchona bark. These are some of the examples. Certain bitters have more alcohol contents, certain have less alcohol content, and it also depends on the type. certain bitters and medicinal compounds which as alcohol are not taxable because they are not considered as alcoholic beverages. And remember, bitter is bitter in flavor, taste, like that, or bittersweet flavor. It is sold as a digestives. When we say digestive, it is after the food, after having a meal, you consume the bitter. So that is why it is called digestive. And it is also used in preparation of cocktails. Normally, for an example, I can give a best example is when person get hangover, if they consume a 15 ml or a 30 ml of bitter, say Angostura bitter, a lot of bitters are there, the hangover will go away. So it is used for medicinal purposes. How is potable alcohol obtained? That is, drinkable alcohol obtained. There are three ways of obtaining the alcohol, potable alcohol. That is, drinkable alcohol, that is through fermentation method, brewing method, and distillation method. So there are three methods in obtaining the alcohol, that is potable alcohol, that is through fermentation, brewing, and distillation. So we will see these three things in the coming slides. Let's see what is fermentation means. Fermentation is the reaction of yeast and sugar, or marrying of yeast and sugar, which gives alcohol and carbon dioxide. I already told you, the juices which is having sugar, the juices made from foods particularly which is having sugar content, where the yeast is added. Okay, some juices they use yeast, some juices they never use yeast. Depends upon the manufacturer or producer, you can say. So sugar in fruit or grains is converted into alcohol by the action of yeast. So fermentation, we can say simply action of yeast and sugar, which gives alcohol and carbon dioxide. So how does we get this? Let us see. Developed by the germination or malting. Grains, when we talk about grains, normally the grain should be germinated, which is converted into malt. Malt is a germinated cereal or grain, usually barley, used in brewing and distilling. For an example, beer and whiskey. So the germination or malting is done in that. So we come to malting. What is malting? It is a process of steeping, germinating, and drying the grain or cereal to convert it into malt. That is what malting. Again, I will repeat. It is a process of steeping. That is, steeping means you put it in water. You are putting the barley in water. That is called steeping. so that during the process that germinates, you remove that, from the water germination takes place. Okay, that is sprouting, we can say. And drying the grain or cereal to convert it into the malt. So I already told you what is malt. It is malt is a germinated cereal grain, usually barley, which is used in brewing and distilling for making beer and whiskey. The fermentation can be controlled in making of wine or wines, any type of wine, white wine, red wine, rose wine, sparkling wine, fortified wine, sherry, port, madeira, marsala, malaga, aromatized wine, you can say vermouth, everything, your fermentation can be controlled. And remember, the wine should, or the time, it takes time to mature. They need time to mature. So it takes 1 month, 2 months, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, like that. It goes on. Remember, carbon dioxide is a byproduct. I already told you, yeast and sugar reacts, it gives alcohol and carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide can be trapped and used as a byproduct. So it can be, the carbon dioxide can be retained in the case of beers and champagne or sparkling wine. When we say champagne, champagne is a sparkling wine which comes from the region of France, Champagne region of France. It is also called the celebrity wine. So some of the fermented alcoholic beverages are wines, cider, perry. So let's see what is wine. That is, how does the wine come? Wine comes from the grapes, are made out of grapes, grape juice which is fermented, you get wine. Cider is made out of apple, which is fermented apple juice, you get cider. Perry is made out of fermented perry juice, pear juice. So perry is made out of pears, cider is made out of apple, wines are made out of grapes, etc. Wines are matured in wooden barrels and then in bottles. Here, maturation means changes in wine after fermentation and bottling. Wooden barrel or cask is a hollow cylindrical container with a bulging center. Next, we come to the robust wine. When we say robust wine, means that are intense and full-bodied wines. That means higher in alcohol content. These are aged in wooden cask as they are able to withstand contact with the wood. Note, when the wine matures in the wood, it takes on woody flavor for the first few weeks and gradually diminishes, leaving the aroma. Now let us see delicate wines. The term used to describe light to medium weight wines with good flavors. I'll again repeat, delicate wines means, this is used to describe light to medium weight wines with good flavors. These wines are aged in bottles and not in wooden barrels, as their flavor will be dominated by the wood. Wines aged in wood
comes in contact with oxygen. Wood is a porous material, so that the oxygen can easily get into the wood. Wines aged in bottles do not come in contact with oxygen. Wines aged in wooden vats for periods ranging from 6 months to 2 years. So, during the aging process, the wine takes the color, the flavor from the wood. Note, vats are made exclusively from oak wood, and they may be raw or toasted on the inside. Again, I repeat, vats are made exclusively from oak wood, and they may be raw or toasted on the inside. The manufacturers may opt for mild, medium, or dark wood for aging. So let me give you some examples on oak wood. Here are they: Allier, Limousin, Nevers, Tronchoy, and Vosges. These are some of the examples of oak wood. During the maturation process, the oxygen in the air comes in contact with the drain through the porous of the wood, causing oxidation. This is what I earlier said. The oxygen stabilizes the color and the character of the drink. The new cask contributes wood, tannin, and vanilla flavor to the wine. Toasting inside the oak vat releases the vanilla flavor and minimizes the smell of the wood. If matured in dark toasted vat, the wine gets tasty aroma and flavor. Remember, if matured in dark toasted vat, the wine gets tasty aroma and flavor. Now, what does it mean? Toasting here refers to in vat. That means the inside of the barrel, which is exposed to the fire, heat, wherein the liquid in the wood, which becomes into caramel. So that is what toasting means. The purpose of toasting is to give the taste and color to the wine. The wine aged in smaller vat of capacity of 225 liters called barrique. Smaller casks have smaller quantity of wine, which has more contact with wood. The sediments of fermented drinks settle down at the bottom of the vat. The sediment here, it refers to the impurities, which will be settled down at the bottom of the cask. The red wines are matured in wood for as long as they can withstand oxidation because of their tannin content. But it is not so in case of white wine. The white wines are matured for a short time in wood as they do not have tannin to protect them from oxidation. All wines must be free from yeast when bottled. Wines continue aging in the bottles, though they do not come in contact with oxygen. The color changes from purple to carmine in case of red wines, and from greenish to yellow to gold in case of white wines. The acids in wines such as tartaric, malic, etc. are changed to esters, which give bouquet or scent to the wine when they interact with the alcohol. Wine loses some of its astringency as the tannins settle during aging. The profile of the wine changes over a period of time. Great vintages, that is years, great vintage wines develop for a decade and then slowly starts deteriorating after reaching their peak. Therefore, bottled wines which have matured should be consumed quickly. Remember, bottled wines which have matured should be consumed quickly. As I already told, the finest oak comes from nervous, limousin, Vosges, Trancoise, and Alias areas of France. Oak is the preferred wood for aging. Some manufacturers use chestnut or redwood. The drinks acquire their alcoholic content by fermenting the liquid which contains sugar. Example, wine, cider, and perry. Let's talk about brewing. Brewing is by steeping a starch source in water and fermenting the resulting sweet liquid with yeast. I'll once again repeat. Brewing is by steeping a starch source in water and fermenting the resulting sweet liquid with yeast. Normally, barley is the popular cereal grain. It may be done in a brewery by a commercial brewer, at home by a home brewer, or by a variety of traditional methods. So you can see that there is a lot of methods in making a beer or a brewing. Examples are beer, sake, etc. The fermented mash of fruit or grain is heated through pot still or pattern still, which we will be discussing in the coming topics. Alcohol evaporates at lower temperature, that is ethyl alcohol or ethyl alcohol, 78 degrees Celsius, it evaporates. Flavoring agents can be trapped and condensed to a liquid by cooling. Pure alcohol has no color, taste or smell and is used in compounding other beverages such as liqueurs. So when we say liqueurs means it is sweetened after dinner drink. The alcohol, water and congeners can be drawn off and blended again to obtain the required flavor of the original ingredient. All distilled drinks are colorless. The color, either the color will be added in the form of caramel or the spirit takes the color from the wood. Some of the examples are brandy, whiskey, dark rum, gin, vodka, etc. or distilled alcoholic beverages. Now let us see what is spirit. Spirit is a portable alcoholic beverage. Portable means here it is drinkable. These are obtained, spirit is obtained from the distillation of an alcohol containing liquid. That means fermented liquid. Fermented liquid is distilled in a pot still or patent still. In distillation, all the alcohol can be separated from the liquid. So we can say 100% pure alcohol is spirit. Now let us see classification of alcoholic beverages. The alcoholic beverages can be classified into fermented, brewed and fermented, distilled. So this is alcoholic beverage is classified into three: fermented, brewed and fermented, distilled. So when we say fermented, again this is classified into three: wines, cider, perry. So when we talk about wines, this can be classified into stable wine, sparkling wine, fortified wine, aromatized wine. Cider, perry, these are all fermented alcoholic beverages. When we say brewed and fermented, beer is a brewed alcoholic beverage. Sake is a fermented alcoholic, brewed and fermented alcoholic beverage. Let us see distilled alcoholic beverage. So distilled alcoholic beverages are classified into three. One is spirit, liqueurs, then UDV. So spirits are classified into whiskey, rum, gin, brandy, tequila, vodka, etc. Liqueurs, there are a lot of liqueurs we have. Some of the examples are Curaçao, Corum, Tia Maria, Crème de Banane, Crème de Cacao. Then we have UDV. These are fruit brandies, Applejack, Calvados, etc. So let us see beer. So beer is a brewed and fermented alcoholic beverage. It is made from barley, wheat, rice, etc. And remember, it is flavored with hops. When we talk about sake, sake is an ancient fermented beverage made in China. So the main ingredient in production of sake is rice. Sake is produced in Japan, some part of China, other Asian countries, and Hawaii and California. Normally, it is a Japan drink. Sake is a Japanese drink. When we say gin, gin is a flavored alcoholic beverage. So it is produced by redistilling high proof spirit. The main flavoring agent used in gin is juniper berries, and also other flavoring agents are used in preparation of gin. Gin is the national drink of England. Vodka. Vodka is a neutral spirit made from the fermentation and distillation of grain mash, and then it is rectified. It is the national drink of Russia, and Poland. It has no flavor, aroma, color, etc. Nowadays, we can see a lot of flavored vodkas in market. Next, we come to the tequila. Tequila is a fermented and distilled alcoholic beverage made from blue-green agave plant. Produced in specific geographic area of Mexico known as tequila, which is within the state of Jalisco. If this tequila is produced outside this geographical limit, it is called mezcal. The tequila has become synonymous with the culture and heritage of Mexico. Next, we come to the rum. Rum is an alcoholic beverage distilled from the fermented byproduct of sugarcane. Sometimes sugarcane juice is also used in making of rum. Here the byproduct means it is molasses. It is molasses. Brandy. Brandy is a spirit made by fermenting and distillation of fruit juice. When made from fruits other than grapes, the word brandy is linked with the name of the fruit. When the label reads brandy alone without any qualifying description, it should be understood that it is made from grapes. I will repeat, when the label reads brandy alone without any qualifying description, it should be understood that it is made from grapes. Brandy, in fact, has been characterized as the soul of wine. That is, it is made from grape juice, fermented grape juice, and it is distilled. The word brandy has originated from the Dutch word brandewijn, meaning burnt wine, which eventually got shortened to brandy. Let us see cognac. Cognac is defined as the brandy produced from the Charente and Charente Maritime department of the West Central France city of Cognac. It can very well be understood that all cognacs are brandy, but not all brandies are cognac. Remember, all cognacs are brandy, but not all the brandies are cognac. Let us see UDV. UDV is a clear, colorless fruit brandy produced by means of fermentation and double distillation. The fruit flavor is typically very light. Next, we come to the Calvados. It is an apple brandy. Calvados is produced in the region of Calvados in Normandy, France. The apples grown in the region are carefully hand-picked, ripened, and crushed to extract the juice, is fermented, then distilled twice to become Calvados. Calvados is aged in oak casks for years before being bottled and sold. Let us see whiskey. Whiskey or whiskey, the term K-Y or K-E-Y, K-E-Y in terms of Irish, Canadian, etc. is a type of distilled alcoholic beverage made from fermented grain mash. Various grains are used for different varieties, including barley, corn, rye, and wheat. Curaçao. It is a liqueur flavored with the dried peel of the citrus fruit grown on the island of Curaçao, Caribbean. Cider is normally made out of apple, hard apple or hard cider, they say in the US, is an alcoholic beverage made from the fermented juice of apples. Cider is popular in United Kingdom, especially in the West Country, and widely available. The juice of any variety of apple can be used to make cider, but cider apples are best. Now we come to the Tiamaria, is a liqueur. Tiamaria is a dark liqueur made originally in Jamaica using Jamaican coffee beans. The main flavor ingredients are coffee beans, Jamaican rum, vanilla, and sugar, blended to an alcoholic content of 20%. We come to the Perry. Perry is an alcoholic beverage made from fermented pears. So similar to the way how the cider is made from apples. It has been common for centuries in England, particularly in the three counties, Gloucestershire, Herefordshire, and Worcestershire. It is also made in parts of South Wales and France, especially Normandy and Anjou. Let's see Applejack. Applejack is a strong apple-flavored alcoholic drink produced from apples, popular in the American colonial period. The name derives from jacking, a term for increasing, that is increasing the alcohol content, and specifically for freeze distilling, the traditional method of producing the drink. Okay, we come to the wine. Wine is an alcoholic beverage made from grapes. So some of the species, we general species is Vitis vinifera. Even though we have Vitis labrusca, a French American hybrid, so most of the grapes grown is from Vitis vinifera species. Fermented without the addition of sugar, acid, enzymes, water, or other nutrients. Yeast consumes the sugar in the grapes and converts it to ethanol and carbon dioxide. These are some of the spirits. So finally, no alcohol beyond this point. Thank you very much for listening.